What's going on, everyone? This is Summer the Two. Welcome you guys back to another exciting episode of TLTPG's Pokemon Black Randomizer Nuzlocke. In the last episode, you guys, the craziest thing happened. Believe it or not, we made it to the Elite Four and we battled and whooped every single one of their asses out. I'm sorry, I'm very cocky right now because I just got finished recording the last episode and I just wanted to jump right into this episode because I don't know. I'm just ready. I'm ready to record. I'm ready to do this. And so in today's episode, you guys, we are going to be getting into some heavy, heavy story. There are going to be a lot of voices being flung around, and I can't wait to try and remember all of them for sure. But let's go ahead and get a quick team recap, because, you know, that is one of the reasons why I am here. We have RuPaul the Milotic, who is level 49, holding the Wave Incense, who is somehow an adamant nature. Don't know how that happened. But no, Surf, Hydro Pump, Twister, and Recover. Next up, we have Edison, the oldest squad member on our team. The Zebstrika holding a Scope Lens because we want her to get some of those crits. She knows Spark, Wild Charge, Sacred Sword, and Flame Charge. Following up, we got Popeye the Blaziken, who knows the Zoom Lens because some of his moves just don't hit, such as Blaze Kick and Magma Storm. He also has Brave Bird and Double Kick to round out his moveset. Following up, we have the beauty herself, Lilith, level 48. The Lilligant holding Leftovers, no Seed Flare, Petal Dance, Quiver Dance, and Mega Drain. I need to remember to possibly teach Spore to this thing. I gotta do that. But what would I get rid of? No idea. Probably Mega Drain. Then following up, we got Tucson the Terrakion, level 49, holding the Fist Plate to power up that Sacred Sword, knows Rock Slide, Bullet Punch, and Swords Dance from last episode as well. And I cannot wait to set up with this thing and wreck house. Let me repeat that. I cannot wait to wreck house with Tucson, because it's happening today. I guarantee you. And then finally, we have Difficult Lugia, level 49, holding the Rocky Helmet because Lugia is so fat and she just likes to hit back. Knows Extrasensory, Aeroblast, Surf, and Dragon Rush. Ooh, pardon me. Gummy bears are getting to me. Alright, let me go ahead and heal up the squad, or at least, I believe, just RuPaul. Yeah, RuPaul's the only one that's really taking any damage. And then, let's go over, let's find Spore. Where's Spore? There it is. And we're gonna go ahead and just teach it to Lilith. So scary that everyone can learn it, actually. And with that, I'm gonna go ahead and pop up to the top window. You guys won't see anything for a quick second. Gotta click back on. But let's get back into this. You know, here we see the middle tower has been activated. Let us descend with Tucson leading the way. As we continue on with our Elite Four challenge and finishing up the story mode and the Nuzlocke for this series. Okay. By the way, OCD as hell, but I hate how you can't run directly up the middle of this. And it's two tile slots in the middle. It irritates the absolute hell out of me. But then you're in the middle here. It just doesn't make any sense. Gonna go ahead and save right here. Because I don't know what's going to happen. Like, I kind of know, but then I don't. You know? Oh, I'm so excited. If you guys are excited too, please hit the like button down below, please. Let's go ahead and get on with this. It's over. Never again will Pokemon be made to suffer or be held captive by humans. It's all thanks to my friend Zekrom. You may have the title champion, but you can't stop me with just a title. Your soft heart has left you weak. Years ago, you lost your Pokemon, your partner, to sickness. In order to forget the pain in your heart, you wandered Unova. Who knows for how long it's been since you've had to fight with your full strength. I actually kind of like that about you, though. As a trainer who far outmatches the champion, I shall issue an order across Unova. Trainers of the world, free your Pokemon. Like, bruh, I beg you, like, totally, like, separating the people from, like, their Pokemon? Do, like, anything but that! You and I both put our beliefs on the line and fought with all of our strength, and I won. Do not say another word. I've been waiting. In the future I envisioned, you obtained a stone, and indeed you have. The Light Zone. Stone. Zekrom is responding to it. Stop. This is not a suitable place for the legendary dragons. From the ground, rise up, the castle of Team Plasma! Surround the Pokemon League! And cutscene as hell. We're gonna go ahead and actually pop this to the bottom screen, because it's taking place on the bottom screen, and I'll pop it back up, but... stuff be happening, yo! Like, stuff is happening on both screens, and I wish I could show you both, but I think this is where the action is, right here. Just started off on the lower screen, so... gonna grab a gummy bear while this awesome cutscene ensues. And it's crazy to think that this castle is just underneath everything. I mean, like, how could no one know this? It's a complete mansion. Stairway to Heaven playing in the background, anyone? Okay. Gummy bears, sorry. What has just appeared is Team Plasma's castle. Oh, I gotta click back on the screen. The king's words will resound from the heights to all below. You must come to the castle as well. Everything will be decided there. Whether people will be liberated from Pokemon, or whether Pokemon and people will live together. We will see whose belief is stronger, and our results will change the world. Gummy bear. Mr. Algar, you're a wreck. It's not fitting for the champion. Like, bruh, you did like so well to get this far. Somehow I beat the Pokemon League, but it wasn't easy. I have to like congratulate ya. Not him though, not TLTPG, bruh. Like, he's not even here. I became stronger because I understood what I want to do. TLTPG, tell end this. Some people grow stronger by being with Pokemon. My Pokemon and I are proof. Together we learned and became stronger. Like, I totally lost, bruh. I should have like been able to like demonstrate that, you know, bond between like me and my Pokemon. That would like have totally shown that brat the worthlessness of his like outrageous weed, I mean dreams. So like his convictions were like the real thing. So like, dude, be careful. The ones who like change the world are always the ones who like pursue their dreams. Like TLTPG, bruh. Even if Pokemon and people are like separated, like nothing good will come of it. Please let him like know that. All right, let us venture into N's castle. Had to pop the neck. I'm gonna go ahead and put our dowsing machine on just in case there's some of those extra items lying around. We have entered N's castle. And this is where shit gets difficult with the voices. Those in accord with fate are preserved, and those who rebel against fate perish. When the way is forgotten, duty and justice appear. One can lose the forest for the trees. If you make a mistake and do not correct it, that is the second mistake. Superior men understand what is right, inferior men understand what will sell. And there are not two suns in the skies, nor two sovereigns over the people. Well, if anything should happen to our king, it would be disastrous. It would ruin Getsis's perfect plan. I just spat everywhere. Our Lord End will be disappointed, but the six of us shall defeat you here. Can you manage that? I know who this is, by the way. I know who this is. Clay! This man! Ah! The music, too! Still standing, are you, TLTPG? You! Your drift fails! I ain't just me. Oh yeah, the whole squad rolling in. The squad has arrived. So sorry. Not only are we stronger than you, but there are a lot of us, man. Cursed gym leaders. Like, ignoring like Team Plasma, That would be like a terrible thing for us, like, gym leaders to do. Oh my god, what was Berg? Oh, it was Berg's voice. Oh, Bianca asked us to come to. Naruto. What voice did I give Skyla? Oh my god. I'm fine, don't worry. Don't want to do her voice, no need to worry.
Holder of the Lightstone, please proceed.
Yo, the squad just rolled up. Let's go ahead and explore, yo. You know what? I'm actually quite surprised I remembered everyone's voices. Except for Skyla. I think I might have messed up on Skyla. Let me know in the comments if I did. But like, legit, that was the cool. I love that. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and just talk to everyone. See what they give us. See if there's anything. I don't believe that there's an encounter in here, unfortunately. Let's see. Come. In this castle, you may rest your Pokemon and access your PC. Fear not. First, have your Pokemon rest in that room. When they are healed, it is our Lord End's wish that you be moved into the innermost part of this castle. Yo, Kagebusha no Jutsu up in here. Huh? Speaking of Naruto.
I am Anthea. Chena, before you go confront my Lord End, please take a moment to rest.
Yo, thanks, fam. What about you? Okay. I can only imagine that there's a PC in the background, if need be. Nope. Okay. Said that there was a PC, but at least she healed her Pokemon, which is super nice, because I do know that with a lot of my moves, I'm actually quite low with PP. There should be an item somewhere, I think. There should be... There it is. There, I know there's at least one item in here. Found a Quick Claw. Eh, not the best. I believe that there's actually a, what is it? A TM in here somewhere, right? We can't surf, so we'll head on up. Ooh, hello. Now we can infiltrate the Pokemon storage system inside every trainer PC. Really? Wow, didn't even know this was a thing from the old games. Oh, here's my PC. Okay, so just in case we did need to switch out Mons, if they did die, which I'm glad they didn't, I'm really glad they didn't, but I did have some Pokemon in the back, you know, like, Drag Queen and Drew, not necessarily level 48, but, you know, 42 to at least hold their own, if need be. Alright, we're just gonna continue walking around. An energy root, not bad, not bad, not bad. I believe that heals 200 HP, so it's like a hyper potion. I believe this is End Room, right? Nope, I think that's next floor up there. He doesn't understand why a Pokemon could get attached to him. I obtained an Ultra Ball from this person. Why? Why? Oh! Whoa! No, I didn't want to do that! Whoa. Oh my god. I was so scared, I almost said I had to redo everything. I was about to be mad than the bitch. I'm sorry, that is definitely not mine. That is not my... I'm sorry. A battle between you and our Lord N will reveal whether our Lord N is an ideal hero. It will also reveal how you feel about protecting the current world, where people live with Pokemon. Okay. Disperse.
Why are you making noise back there, huh? Why you laying all over my paper?
That room was the world that was provided to our Lord N.
Here's Lord N's room.
I don't feel anything even when I go in that room, but you may feel something.
Yeah, this freaking weird as hell childish baby room. This is so weird. A Dawnstone, okay. But yeah, this is weird as all hell. I'm not gonna lie, guys. I get really creeped out in that room. there should be one more item. Right there. I think this is the last item we get. An ice gem. Ugh. Not worth it. Okay. We're almost there. I know half the episode is almost used up, but we're actually gonna extend today's episode, hopefully, depending on what happens. Is there anything else over here? Nope. So I believe this is it. I believe we just go straight through here. I'm gonna go ahead and save right now. We're still going in with Tucson. We are still going in with Tucson. Let's go, guys. And it's Getsis.
Welcome, holder of the Light Stone. The castle that appeared as if it were enveloping the Pokemon League is a symbol. It means Unova will change. The king of this castle is the strongest trainer in the world. He's accompanied by the legendary Pokemon. He has defeated the champion. Added to all that, his heart burns with the desire to improve the world. If that's not what makes a hero, what more do you need? Now that the stage is set, we can seize people's minds and hearts. We can bring into being the world that I know, that Team Plasma desires more easily than you can imagine.
His voice still hurts.
We, and only we, will use Pokemon, and we shall rule the powerless populace. I've been waiting so long for this. I've kept my silence so no one could piece together what I planned. Now those painful days are at an end. Go, onward! Discover whether you have what it takes to be a hero.
Oh my gosh. I can already feel it in my voice. It's going. That was a terrible voice to do. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. He sits atop his throne. What I desire is a world for Pokemon and Pokemon alone. I will separate Pokemon from people, so Pokemon can regain their original power. It's time to settle this once and for all. My determination is absolute. I will prove the value of my beliefs, even if it means my Pokemon friends get hurt. Since you've come this far, I believe you are equally determined. If that's so, then prove it to me. Show me the depths of your determination.
Yo, squad, roll up.
You came all this way to battle me, but Reshiram is not responding. You haven't yet been recognized as the hero, have you? How disappointing. I actually kind of liked you a little. Through our many battles, I got the feeling that you might be a trainer who truly cares for Pokemon. But I was kidding myself. The idea of trainers getting to know each other through battles is ridiculous. You have two options. Challenge me to a fight you can't win, or leave this place and watch the birth of a new world where Pokemon are free of people. Zekrom, come to me!
No, I actually just thought of something. Hold on. Cutscene. What actually signifies that the Snuzlocke is over? Because I know when it comes to regular Nuzlocke rules, it's once you beat the story mode of the game, but that's coming up, but we don't beat the champion. So, I'm watching this cutscene, which is really badass, by the way, super badass. Do we actually... could this be the final episode? Because we have enough time to push it to be extra long, because we captured the legendary, capture the legendary, then we battle Getsis, and then the story's over, right? So do we win the Nuzlocke after that? I don't know. I'm actually going to leave that up to you guys. We're going to go through this episode and do what I said. We're going to battle and capture our legendary, which honestly won't take us any time whatsoever, because I do have the Match Ball for that reason.
Then we'll battle Getsis himself. Then after that, once the credits start rolling, you know, everything will be fine and dandy. But then, I don't know. I'll leave that to you guys. I really want TLTPG's opinion on this. And anyone that watches. Because if so, I wouldn't mind continuing on to challenge the Elite Four again. I do know their levels are crazy higher than what it is here. But I don't know. Because usually with Nuzlocke rules, it's the story mode. You beat the story mode, and anything post-game is just post-game. You don't have to worry about that. So for now, I'm probably gonna call this the final episode, unless you guys convince me otherwise. That's all I'm gonna say. This is the last episode. I didn't think about that. I really didn't think about that. But the Lightstone is trembling inside the bag. Your Lightstone is. I mean, Reshiram is. Here we go, B. It's really confusing, mostly. The Lightstone draws in the aura of the surroundings and converts into a powerful force, which is now being released. Beyblade, let it rip! There he is. There's Reshiram. But where's Zekrom? I mean, he was just standing right behind him, but I guess he's not there anymore. But honestly, that whole thing has me very confused. But I'm not going to worry about it. I'm just going to focus on this, because this is where we need to be right now. And if this is that last episode, then this is the last episode. And it's going to be worth it.
Zekrom and Reshiram. They were once one life, one Pokemon. Complete opposites, and yet the same. Zekrom and Reshiram are Pokemon that appear before the hero they recognize. Ah, I see. You really are a hero too. I'll tell you what that Pokemon is saying to you. I want to battle with you. Try to make me your friend and ally. I plans to test you to see if you are really pursuing truth. I also am curious to see how powerful you are. Now catch Reshiram and make it to your ally.
Alright, we going balls deep. We have the Master Ball. I'm gonna go ahead and save just in case the game crashes and I can easily load this back up. And let's go! I don't know what that is. Is that a Heatran? It sounded like a Heatran, to be quite honest. Oh my god. The irony in this couldn't be more beautiful. It's a Regigigas. The irony in this, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my god. For those of you who don't know, Regigigas could have been one of our starters, and I initially didn't want it to be our starter, because I personally thought all the Regis only got explosion up until like level 20-something. But not Regigigas. Regigigas has a full entire moveset that absolutely just has destroyed our team time and time again. But I'm going to go ahead and throw the Master Ball, because we have it, but the irony of us actually catching Regigigas as our final legendary for the legendary is, I don't know, it's beautiful irony. It's just such beautiful irony that the fact that the starter that I actually wanted in the end ended up being our legendary. It was like our journey to find Regigigas. It has said to have made Pokemon that look like itself from a special ice mountain, rocks, and magma. Give a nickname to the caught Regigigas. Absolutely. Ooh, pardon me. Absolutely. for Regigigas, we are gonna name you... Oh gosh, what do we call you? You think that that because I wanted Regigigas for our starter that I would have had a decent name, but you know what? I really don't. It's Regigig... Oh my god. What do we call this thing? It's killed so many of our mons. I feel like I should hate it. We are gonna call you... We are just gonna call... We're gonna call you Frank for Frankenstein. I feel that adds up, because he's very slow to start, but once he gets going, you know, everything. Big hulking monster. That's just beautiful. Add Regigigas to your party from the box? I mean... It would be nice to have Regigigas on the squad, but who would I take out? Honestly, I probably don't want to do that. No. We're not adding Regigigas. We're not adding Frank. I want to battle N as he is. As we are, with our own squad. Hold on, your Pokemon are hurt. There's no triumph to be gained in battling a weakened opponent. So N healed our Pokemon, which we really didn't need because we just threw that Master Ball. Now, I will create the future I desire. I shall sweep you before me. He's going for that 6-0 sweep, please, but hold on, let's listen to this. And he starts things off with the Dragonite, ladies and gentlemen. Holy hell. He's level 52. We're gonna go ahead and Swords Dance up. I probably should have broken Multiscale now that I'm thinking about it. He's gonna go for the Agility, so he can definitely outspeed us, which is actually really, really scary. Agility Dragonite is nothing to be messed with, because he probably already outsped. He's gonna go straight up for the Aqua Tail. Oh no, that's super effective on us. Toussaint, are you living? Toussaint. We do live it. We go for the Rock Slide. How much is this gonna do? Oh my gosh. We get the knockout. It's super effective. Dragonite goes down, ladies and gentlemen. Toussaint coming through here. Next, he's gonna send in an Aggron. It is Steel Rock type. We are going to stay and we're going to heal and go for that Sacred Sword. Because I know, while Aggron can hit us very hard, I know we can probably eat up any decent hit. We're going to go ahead and use a full Restore. Just because I have them, I bought them. We didn't get to use them for the Elite Four, but this is absolutely crazy. He has a monstrous team. He has a Dragonite and an Aggron. He goes for the Iron Tail, which should be neutral damage on us, I believe. Did he just crit us? Oh my god! He just straight up one-shot! Oh my god! Why? Am I regretting not putting Frank on the squad? Yeah. Our Toussaint is gone! Oh my god! I don't know what to do! This thing is gonna... Blaze Kick. Blaze Kick is all... It's gonna go for the Protect. Really? Okay, Popeye, I need you to get the crits of all crit. He's gonna go for double Protect. But he fails. We go for that Blaze Kick. Can we get a burn? A burn would be actually really, really nice. Or a crit. That does nothing! Why does that do so little? Why does that do so little? We're gonna go ahead and Magma Storm. I am so scared right now. Aggron goes down. Oh my god, Popeye. I cannot believe that just happened. Toussaint goes down. I'm gonna keep this updated. Because if this is the last episode, I want this to stay updated. Togekiss is coming in. We're gonna go ahead and set Edison in. It's not a fairy type. We're gonna go ahead. We're probably gonna wild charge it just to get that knockout. But holy hell. Honestly, holy hell. He goes for extreme speed. Hello? Oh my gosh. I didn't know Togekiss got access to extreme speed. We don't pick up the knockout. He's gonna go ahead and heal, so we'll be able to get a spark off. No, he's gonna go for the extreme speed. What am I thinking? I'm healing up myself. Okay, N does go for the full restore. Okay, that's good. Oh my god, are you serious? Why is this happening? We are gonna go ahead and spark, hopefully get a paralysis off. It's gonna go for the extreme speed again. When does Togekiss get extreme speed? That's what I wanna know. I've never known a Togekiss to have extreme speed. It's a two-hit KO. We're gonna go ahead, heal up again. Extreme speed. Extreme speed should only have 5. This is like the third or fourth time it hits. My god, and it's stab at the same time. Uh-oh. Hello. Sorry, guys. I just got a call from work. I'm not paying attention. I heal up. He hits us with the extreme speed. That should be his last extreme speed, hopefully. I'm just going to go ahead and probably stall him. Okay, Edison's HP is... It goes for another extreme speed. Gosh. Why is he not out of extreme speeds yet? Goes for the air slash. Okay. Okay, he should be out of extreme speeds. Let's go for that spark. We outspeed. This should take the Togekiss down. Why is this team so scary? To think we have to face Getsis after this. Chansey? We should be good because Chansey can't do anything back to us except for Seismic Toss, and we are definitely living. We're gonna go ahead and Sacred Sword. It doesn't have Eviolite. It slowly drops, and we do one hit KO this Chansey, which is super beautiful. Edison grows to level 51 after that. Next comes in a very scary Pokemon, which I don't know what to do. I'm probably gonna send in Difficult to take care of it. No, we're gonna go ahead and send in Lilith to spore this Stoutland, because Stoutlands are extremely, extremely scary. Sorry guys, I know I shouldn't be on my phone, but it's just stuff with work and I just gotta get it resolved. Alright, I should be good. I should be good. So sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. We are gonna go ahead and spore. We outspeed the Stoutland. Holy cow. We outsped a Stoutland. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and set up a... Try and set up two quiver dances. Woke up first turn. It goes for retaliate. This is gonna hurt. Yeah, that hurt a lot. We're gonna go ahead and full heal, hopefully. No, I outspeed it. Why didn't I just go for sport? I'm an idiot. I am an absolute idiot. Goes for retaliate again. It shouldn't do this much this time, I don't think. Yeah, okay, it's doing less, it seems. Okay, so you can definitely eat up another one of those if we do, if it does outspeed it up. But we're gonna go ahead and skid a spore off. There's nothing much more it can really do to us. I'm gonna go for another quiver dance and speed this up just a little bit, just to get just some of these things just go slow. These animations. Stoutland woke up again, and he goes for a roar. So that was all for a waste. And we go into Lugia, which I'm actually okay with. I'm actually quite okay with. We are going to arrow blast it. Hopefully he doesn't... I know he's going to crunch us, but hopefully we'll be able to eat it. Rocky Helmet will be able to take him out. He goes for the crunch. How much is this going to do to us? Does a decent amount. Does about 40-50 points of damage. Gets hit with that Rocky Helmet. Arrow Blast should be able to bring him down. He's going to hit us with a physical move, and it should take him out. Goes for the crunch. Actually, Rocky Helmet may not... And he does get that special... I mean, that defense fall. But actually, you know what? Rocky Helmet does take him out. Hello! In comes a Frostlass, and I know a Popeye. We are using our team to our full advantage. It's End's last Pokemon. So we're gonna go ahead and Blaze Kick. It's gonna go for Hail. Waste of a move, Popeye, finish N up right now. Oh my gosh, there's so much going on. We straight up knock it out because Frostlass is glass. And we defeat Champion N. Everything's ruined. The ideals I had. The dreams Pokemon had. But Tucson is gone. Are you so sad? Zekrom and I were beaten. Your truth, your feelings, they were stronger than mine. It seems... Reshiram and Zekrom. Each of them choosing a different hero. Is that even possible? Two heroes living at the same time, one that pursues truth and the other that pursues ideals. Could they both be right? I don't know. It's not by rejecting different ideas, but by accepting different ideas, that the world creates a chemical reaction. This is truly the formula for changing the world.
Uh-oh. After all that, do you think you're still worthy of sharing the name Harmonia with me? You good-for-nothing boy!
Oh, wow! That voice.
To start with, I spurred N into pursuing ideals. The reason we reawakened the legendary Pokemon now was to give my Team Plasma Wall power. Power to control the fearful masses. That at least was well done. After saying you had to put your beliefs on the line and battle to see which one chosen by the legendary Pokemon was the true hero, you lost to an ordinary trainer. There isn't such a thing as being too stupid. Add it up and you're nothing more than a warped, defective boy who knows nothing but Pokemon. TLTPG, I never would have thought the legendary Pokemon would choose a trainer like you. It caught me completely off guard. This doesn't change my goal. My plans have not been disrupted. In order to rule this world utterly, in order to manipulate the hearts of people who know nothing, I will have N be the king of Team Plasma. But for that to work, you, since you know the truth, you must be eliminated.
Rule the world? Wasn't Team Plasma's goal to liberate Pokemon?
That was just a convenient lie that I needed to create Team Plasma. Use your head. What's to be gained from letting go of useful things like Pokemon? Certainly, manipulating Pokemon helps people expand their possibilities. That much I can agree with. So it naturally follows that only I should be able to use Pokemon. Like, bruh, you fool. That's like a totally ridiculous idea. You can say whatever you want. A Pokemon, even if it's revered?
I can't do English, I'm sorry.
As a deity, it's still just a Pokemon. TLTPG, so what if it chose you? That doesn't mean you're a threat. Come on, now you'll face me in battle. I can't wait to see the look on your face when you've lost all hope.
TLTPG. No!
I won't allow anyone to stop me, no matter who does that.
And we are straight up going into battle Getsis himself or Sonya. Let it be settled in Mortal Kombat, ladies and gentlemen. He starts things off with the Simisear. Is our team healed? Because if so, I will have to... Yes, unfortunately, Tucson is healed up. He was in the front of our party, so I cannot use him, even though he should be dead. I'm going to go ahead and eat up a hit by switching directly into RuPaul. But for the most part, I cannot use Tucson, even though he is healed. But Simisear is going to straight up go for the Leer. It's level 52. This is scary. But this music, though, just hold on. Okay, I'm sorry. We're almost 50 minutes into this episode. This is almost an hour-long episode. He goes for another Leer, so our defense falls again. It outspeeds us, but the Surf should definitely put in the work. And we just barely missed the knockout, which means he's going to go for that heal. I'm going to go for the Hydro Pump. Hopefully land it. RuPaul, land it. Be the best diva you can be and land this Hydro Pump. Which he does. We should be able to knock this Simisear out now. Perfect. So RuPaul's going to get up to level 50, which is brilliant in and of itself. Okay. Sigalith is next up. Psychic Flying type. Let's go ahead and switch into Edison. So here comes Sigalith. Not the most bulky Pokemon, or it can be, but I'm gonna go for the Spark just to be on the safe side, because I know it's quite fast as well. Let's see how much damage we can do to this thing. We're at level 51, so we almost knock it out. Wild Charge would have done the work. It goes for the Cosmic Power. I'm gonna go for the Wild Charge just because of that extra damage as well as the defense boost on Sigalith. We should still be able to knock it out, which we do. Perfect. Edison putting in the work. This is the final battle. This is the final battle, and we're doing really nice right now. Conkeldurr wants to come in. We're gonna go ahead and go into difficult, and we're gonna go for the Aeroblast. Oh, I'm so nervous, you guys. This is really crazy. This is too crazy right now. Okay. Because Conkeldurr can do everything to us. We're going to go ahead and go for that Aeroblast. Because it is higher stab than Extrasensory. How much do we do to this thing? We do 2/3 to it. That's kind of scary. Especially with that scary face. So now he most definitely will outspeed us. We're going to go for the Extrasensory now. Just so he's going to go for the Stone Edge, and he lands it. And Stone Edge does have a high chance to crit. But he does... Okay. That's scary. That's crazy damage that Conkeldurr did to us. But Extrasensory does pick up the knockout on Conkeldurr. Gosh, this is too scary, guys. I'm literally so nervous. Wants to learn Punishment? What does that do? You're learning that. I totally didn't even know this movie existed. Okay. Here we go. Wants to send an Arcanine. We will send it back in RuPaul, which sucks because Arcanine is my favorite Pokemon of all time. Well, it's up there. It's like top three. I want to say it's my favorite Pokemon. The scary thing is, I know this thing does get Wild Charge. It does get the Intimidate, which doesn't do anything for our Adamant boost. I'm going to go straight up for the Hydro Pump. He goes for the Extreme Speed. Ooh, how are we living with this? Okay, does decent damage. We do land the Hydro Pump. Arcanine should go down. It barely lives on one. Okay, we're gonna go for the Surf. He's gonna go for the Extreme Speed again. Hello? I would have thought he would have healed. But down goes the Arcanine to the Surf. I think he has one more Pokemon after this. So far, so good. So far, so good. A Lopunny. Okay. We can definitely handle a Lopunny. Lilith, get in there. Lilith, get in there. We're gonna Sport, and we're gonna Seed Bomb it. Okay, level 52. Gonna go for the Spore. Goes for the Dizzy Punch. It's a 50% chance, I believe, for a confusion, right? Doesn't land, doesn't get the confusion, but that does a crazy amount of damage to us. We do get the Spore off. We're gonna go ahead and Seed Bomb now, because it's only a normal type. No Mega Lopunnies up in here. Or should I Petal Dance? Let's go straight up for the Petal Dance, actually. It's fast asleep. Lilith, put in work right now, girl. Lilith, put in work. Does 50%. So this next hit should knock it out. Still fast asleep. Beautiful. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And it's a crit! Lilith wants to put in the good work. Hallelujah, praise be it. Be to you, girl. Okay. What is your final Pokemon, good sir? And can Popeye take it out so we have a nice roundabout? Cryogonal, perfect. Everyone besides Tucson got a chance to take a turn on the field. So sad, Tucson. Really sad. So here comes Cryogonal, and Cryogonal is actually a pretty very fast mob, but I'm gonna go ahead and Magma Storm. Goes for the Slash, has a high chance to crit, doesn't get it. Magma Storm goes off. Scope Lens or Zoom Lens helps. This is a Zoom Lens. Helps us land this. Is it enough to knock it out though? It is not, but it is trapped in the swirling magma. We're gonna go for that Blaze Kick, and Popeye is gonna... Is Popeye gonna finish this out for us? He is. Blaze Kick it up, and down goes the Cryogonal. Holy hell. That was actually kind of scary. I'm not gonna lie. Even though we were underleveled on par as far as all of the trainers and stuff throughout this, through the Elite Four, as well as Enin Getsis, I'm not gonna lie, guys, that is pretty damn scary. These were some scary mons. They easily did a lot of damage to my team, as you see, even my walls took heavy hits. So, the fact that Tucson went down to an Iron Tail Aggron is still incredible to me. Because Iron Tail's base power is like, what, 75 and has like an 80, 90% chance to actually hit? It's absolutely insane. Anyway, let's get back to storyline. We're almost 50 minutes in. What? I created Team Plasma with my own hands. I am absolute perfection. I am perfection. I am the perfect ruler of a perfect new world. Like, now, bruh, and do you, like, still think Pokemon and people should, like, be separated, bruh? Mwahaha! Since I couldn't become the hero and obtain the legendary Pokemon myself, I prepared someone for that purpose. N! He's nothing more than a freak without a human heart. Do you think you're going to get through to a warped person like that? Alder is a waste of valuable time. Oh, Alder. Oh, he isn't. Elder, Ith a waste of valuable time, listening to him ramble on. He is the one without a human heart.
Like, bruh, you're right. He's, like, truly pitiful. Like, and bro, I'm sure you have, like, so much to think about and all that. And I, like, know you were not, like, pursuing the ideals of, like, because gets this manipulation, but because, like, your heart was, like, truly inspired, bruh, you were totally able to, like, meet legendary Pokemon, bruh.
But I have no right to be the hero.
Like, bruh, is, like, that legit, though? What, like, you and them, like, totally radical Pokemon are going to do from now on? That's, like, what's really the important thing, right?
Acting like you understand. Up till now, we've been fighting each other over our beliefs. Yet, despite that, why?
Like, and bruh, even if we, like, don't understand each other, like, there's, like, no reason to reject one another, dude. There are, like, two sides to, like, so many arguments. Like, is weed better or cocaine? No one really knows. I'm sorry. Bruh. Is there, like, one point that has, like, all the answers? Like, give it some thought. It's blunt. Deep question.
And they straight up haul his ass away.
I want to talk to you about something.
Such a magical moment, you guys. Such a magical moment with the piano.
God, this is it, though. This could be it, ladies and gentlemen.
It's about when I first met you in Accumula Town. I was shocked when I heard what your Pokemon was saying. I was shocked because that Pokemon said it liked you. It said it wanted to be with you. I couldn't understand it. I couldn't believe that there were Pokemon that liked people. Because up until that moment, I'd never known a Pokemon like that. The longer my journey continued, the more unsure I became. All I kept meeting were Pokemon and people who communicated with one another and helped one another. That was why I needed to confirm my beliefs by battling with you. I wanted to confront you hero to hero. I needed that more than anything. There's no way a person like me, someone who only understands Pokemon, no, actually, I didn't understand them either. No way could I measure up to you when you had met so many Pokemon and were surrounded by friends. The champion has forgiven me, but what I should do now is something I'll have to decide for myself. TLTPG. You said you have a dream. That dream. Make it come true. Make your wonderful dream a reality, and it will become the truth. TLTPG. If anyone can, it's you. Well then. Farewell.
Oh my gosh, you guys. We have beaten the story mode to Pokemon Black. I honestly don't know what to say. That was so crazy. The Elite Four, I will admit, like, this is one of the reasons why I didn't enjoy Gen 5 is the Elite Four was absolute booty. We mollywopped them. But when it came time for the end battle, the irony of the legendary battle, and Getsis' battle, I was legit scared, especially because Tucson was knocked out in one hit. I'm like, this is where things get bad. I'm about to lose three of my Mons. Even though we've lost so many Mons along the way, this Nuzlocke couldn't have gone any better, I feel. And once again, I'm not sure if it's 100% over. I see the credits, and to me that signifies that I beat the story mode for sure, and the Nuzlocke's over. But yet, I haven't entered the Hall of Fame. And I think both of those things are like interchangeable when it comes to actually completing a Nuzlocke, so I don't know if it's completely done yet or not. There's like more towns to go through, yes, more encounters, level ups, but that's all post-story. Unless I just want to train up and battle the Elite Four and the Champion again, maybe I might do that for like an extra episode. Maybe not for Friday, but maybe like the following week, or I don't know, a couple weeks down the line, because I know I do have finals coming up. But for the most part, I'm going to say that, I don't know, I told you guys that we're gonna be left with a choice, but thinking on it now, me personally, I see the credits. That means the game is done. So I feel like this Nuzlocke is over. This is going to be the finale. And if there's a real good push to actually, you know, go back through the Elite Four and the Champion just to see how much stronger they are and have another go at it to actually get into the Hall of Fame, then I'll do that just at a different time on the channel. But the game is saved. The end. And there's no other better way to put that. We're almost an hour in to this finale. And I said this in the last episode, and I'll say it again. I love doing this so much. I love doing this. I'm going to go ahead and actually pause right here. Actually, do this. I'm going to go ahead and just pause it right there. And no, I'm actually going to do this. I'm going to do some live editing. Pull this up. Oh wow, that is not what I wanted at all. Come on. But yeah, I'm gonna leave it like this just because I usually try and do this with the end of some series, but like I said, I didn't have to do this series. I had no free time on my hands. I did this series from the bottom just because I wanted to. From the bottom of my heart, I truly love Pokemon. I love TLTPG and what it stands for. And the fact that my life has completely 180'd from meeting all these great people in this group is phenomenal. And I will definitely be putting the links to our Facebook page and our Tumblr page down below, because I feel like this group should be known. Like, I know that there's a lot of different groups out there and stuff, but this group honestly does care for wanting you to build, build from the ground up your Pokemon skills through battling, breeding, etc. And it's truly incredible. I'd like to give a thanks to everyone at TLTPG for watching this. Thank you guys so much for sticking with me through this, even though I do ramble a lot and I don't know half the things I say and I, you know, do stupid stuff all the time. But hey, that's what makes some of these episodes truly incredible. But I'm gonna quit rambling as it is right now. Thank you all so much for watching. Leave a like and comment down below. If you're new here, please subscribe. I promise there is definitely more content coming in the near future. How far in the future, I can't really say for sure. I'm a college student. I have the finals to focus on right now, but definitely this channel's activity is definitely not going anywhere. But with that, I'm going to wrap this episode up right here. My name is Sunbrother2 guys, representing TLTPG, and we'll see you in the next series.